Hello class, Mr. Linder here, and today we're going to be looking at laboratory 3, which covers tissues. In your laboratory book, we'll be looking at exercise 5. And in this particular laboratory, you're going to be identifying the various types of tissues that make up the human body. You'll be studying epithelial, connective, muscle, and nervous tissue. What I've done is I've pulled up your laboratory link so that you can follow the directions for this particular laboratory. What I want you guys to do is I want you guys to be able to identify what the different tissues look like, and then you can study their locations and their functions. In order to determine what the different tissues look like, I want you guys to do a Google search for the different types of tissues. So I want to show you how to do that. So I have Google pulled up here for you guys to take a look at. And what I want you guys to do is type in the name of the tissue that you want to identify. So the first one here is simple squamous epithelium. And once you type in the name of the tissue, you'll find that it gives you a little definition of that tissue. But what I want you to do is click on images. And what you're going to find is thousands of images of simple squamous epithelium. And this is going to help you identify what this particular tissue looks like so that when you get to a laboratory exam, you'll be able to pick the correct answer when I ask you to identify a particular microscope slide. So what you see here, if we scroll through the images, is all kinds of different slides that have been posted on the internet. And I want to find one that looks similar to your images that you'll find in the textbook. So your textbook or your lab book have tissue samples of the lung, and that's a good place to find simple squamous epithelium. So I'll go ahead and click on this picture here. And what you're looking for with simple squamous epithelium is you're looking for a single layer, that's what simple means, of flat cells. And so you can see the flat squamous cell here. You can see the nucleus of that particular cell, and they're linked together forming a tissue. So this is simple squamous epithelium found in your lungs. And the reason they're flat like this is that they allow for diffusion very easily across their cytoplasm. So in the lungs, it's much easier for oxygen and carbon dioxide to move across a simple squamous epithelium so that we can transfer those respiratory gases. So that shows us a little bit about their functionality related to their location. The next thing you should do is type in another tissue. So what you can do is go back to your search bar and you can type in another type of tissue that you want to look for. So let's say I want to be able to identify osseous tissue. So I go ahead and type in osseous tissue. And I'm still on the images tab. And what you find are various microscope images of bone tissue, because osseous tissue is bone tissue. It's a type of connective tissue. And so I can click on this and magnify it so that you can see what osseous tissue looks like under the microscope. And then you can again work on where is its location, it's found in bones, and then what is its function. And so it's a very hard mineralized connective tissue, so it provides strength and stability to your bones as a function of that particular tissue. And so you'll continue to do this for all of the tissues that are listed in exercise 5 of your lab book. So I'll give you another example. We could do cardiac muscle tissue. And again, we're on the images tab, and so you can see all these different examples of cardiac muscle. So I'll click on cardiac muscle here to enlarge it. And what I want you guys to do is make drawings in your laboratory book, answer the questions that go along with the different activities, and then make sure that you complete the review questions at the end of the lab and upload those as part of your homework. All right, I hope this helps, and I'll talk to you guys later.